Video of this Let's Play is rated M for Mature for these reasons shown here. If you do not want to see any of these at all, I suggest pausing and leaving this video right now. You have been warned. Hello everybody, this is Sportman16, welcoming you back to Let's Play Bayonetta. Last time out, I basically started up a new game and took care of the prologue. So, we're going to be starting out this video with Chapter 1, The Angels of Metropolis. Now, before this chapter actually does get started, a small update. Bayonetta videos are not going to be coming every Friday, because I really don't have patience to wait on my sister to not have classes on Fridays, so what I'm deciding to do is that I'm going to depending on my mood, I'll upload a video every Monday and Wednesday. But again, it's all depending on my mood. And also, as another small update, my 3DS is currently in the process of getting itself fixed. From what my sister told me, that I probably won't get my 3DS back till possibly this coming Thursday. But I don't care how long I have to wait, as long as I get my 3DS back with a fixed 3DS screen. Or basically just gonna probably have a replaced one. Anyway. This is basically what I can do for the sub menu before I start the chapter. I can select any chapter that I desire. I can change the difficulty of this game at any given time. My options were, I can just like, I have different controls that I can set up with. So basically, these are the controls. So basically I can use my bumper to taunt. Yeah, I can actually taunt in this game. And basically all your color buttons are your actions. The pad, only up, left, and right will be your item buttons. I can move the camera with the right stick. I can lock on a target with the RB button, but since this is on very easy mode, it would do it automatically. And I can set the vibrations on or off. In this case for me, they're already turned off. And I can change the camera settings, my sound settings, notes, surrounded output settings, and blah blah. I probably shouldn't waste anybody else's time anymore. I'm just gonna save up real quick. Just gonna overwrite this. Never hurts to be safe. And let's get started with Chapter 1. So, here we go, Chapter 1.
I asked around, and some whale in Europe is trying to fence a huge rock on the black market. He calls it the right eye.
Is this what we're after?
It's part of some set called the Eyes of the World. Fits the bill of what you're after, don't it? Now, here's the funny bit. The stone passes around the halls of power for hundreds of years, vanishes, and then the black market goes white hot for the thing. But the seller wanted an arm and a leg for it, to the point no one could stomach the price. So back goes the stone. But not before everyone figures out where the guy is. You're gonna enjoy doing this one, I bet. I love sticking it to the rich.
Of course, you do.
Don't forget your old buddy Enzo stuck his neck out on this one. Slide me a few fuzzles out of the rich guy's pocket for my troubles, right?
Right.
Anyways, You better get going before the trail gets cold. Off to the middle of nowhere. Paradise of Europe.
Big grid. So, currently right now, we are on the train. I could just basically just, you know, explore around. I can just a current resident, maybe a part of their religious. Oh, didn't mean to start shooting, and they didn't even run. I got a poster, got a little billboard I can check. I think if I remember correctly. I can actually destroy benches to get these Mandagora root. Caribbean crystallization mega root is for. Okay, we got a unicorn horn. Unicorn horn. And then we got this. Bait gecko. Okay, now, just real quick, I'm gonna show you guys the taunt button and what it does. If I hold down, and those are pretty much the taunts. I think I would get a little bonus if I did that to an angered enemy of some sort, but I'm not gonna do that because that's not who I am. This way. Okay. Trying to remember things off the top of my head here, ladies and gentlemen. And we got this thing over here. The wall is emitting a wondrous light. The closer it is, the more brighter. It has ability to respond to a witch's power built in. Do here. I think I'm trying to figure this out. I am! There we go, it's like I had to hit it in order to open it up. So basically your action is for jumping. So I can hold A to extend my jump, and then do a double jump. So, quite obviously, I need a freaking key. Okay, so I'm literally trying to remember everything off the top of my head, and if for some reason, okay, she followed. Okay, now I remember the key was down here. So let's destroy that. key. And just in case, I can actually use the key as a weapon. And just make our way up. And I can also wall jump. Yeah, I'm just gonna destroy you with a key now. Yeah. Destroy my enemies with a key. There we go. Put the key in the lock. Open up. And let's go inside. Got a gold medal because it took me a little while. And right here in front of me is a book. I'll just look at these books some of the time. Okay, so we got a broken down statue. It is a set of two crystal statues, but one's in pieces. It has been destroyed by an unnatural manner, and if it fits of rage power, it'll deeply grudge. So I can't go any further. The wicked weave is a technique used to carry the conduct. Yeah, I've done that already. The Iron Maiden. Get out of here. Yeah, don't even try, pal. And get the pure platinum because I got no damage. And by defeating those enemies, I open the gate. Statue has been repaired. And there's an inscription. Women sages and younger witches with their powers must meet in a test of strength. The lightning will release be a test. Basically, I have to dodge lightning at the right time. And with this, I can be able to run on water. And once I'm there, green L'Oreal. Water shape. Ravana is one of the finals, and okay, so it's kind of like a healer. We'll do that. Slab shatters. And. Am I take it up? How's it going, everybody? Yeah, these are real people, but from where I stand, they're invisible to me. But the game did it in a way to where I can see them. In a way. Try some pottery, try some benches, because hey, you never know. This is just sort of like, just kind of a... Ooh, halos. Grab one of those. It never hurts to look around. Thank you, friend Phipps. I'll find a more better evasion later on. All I have to say is not that posture, though. That posture. And that red portal, up to the left, is basically my entrance to the gates of hell. Well, the bar for that matter.
I knew it. This town's teeming with heaven's little helpers.
No surprise.
It's making my buddies downstairs awfully nervous.
And your point is?
Your point?
Some places in this world are closer to Paradiso or Inferno. The rat hole of the town you and I live in is close to both. But the Vigridians, it got a special air about them. They're closer to Paradiso than anyone should ever be.
Really?
That shit just plain creeps me out.
It would creep anybody out.
I guess I'm gonna have to set up shop here and score me some halos. These stupid rings are worth a fortune back home.
They are.
Since it seems you're spoiled for a fight, if you come across any of these, bring them to me, and I'll hook you up.
Good to know that.
Another one looking to line his pockets.
Hey.
I'm beginning to see why Enzo is so fond of you.
Yep.
Real cute. But let's get one thing straight. Your fights are yours alone.
Well, no
I'm
fooling.
Only here to watch my handiwork in action. so don't get any bright ideas about coming to me for help.
Yeah, like I need your help.
No, you get one thing straight. I'm not the slightest bit interested in the fact that you made these guns.
Yeah.
If you get in my way, I will... How do the Americans put it?
How?
Yes. Bust a cap in your ass.
Right on, baby.
I swear, that's the funniest line she ever said! Seriously, that is heck of funny. Bust a cap in your ass. So yeah, pretty much with this red portal, I can enter the gates of hell at any time, purchase weapons, items, get new moves, and all that stuff. So, without further ado, let's actually enter in. Okay, now I think I'm starting to get the picture. Okay, now I'm starting to get the fighting style now. So it's not just button motors, like... Okay, now I get the button style now. I get it.
I'm here for business or pleasure. Either way, I'll hook you up.
So, basically, if you ever see a little rodent symbol with a thumbs up, basically, it's a symbol, grace of hotness of hot items in his shop. If you're not sure what to go after, look for the face you can trust. So, basically, yeah, I think in some way, shape, or form, I had to unlock different weapons. I got different items I can purchase, but I don't have the currency right now. I can purchase some items, like, here that with the red hot shot, a wondrous demonic medicine that can save a witch from the depths of mortality, automatically used when my health is depleted, but I'm only limited to one. And we got some techniques we can buy. We got air dodge, stiletto, heel slide, name I can't pronounce, heel stomp, break dance, afterburner kick, witch twist, and umbrin portal kick. And the cool thing about it is, I can actually test out these techniques and see if I feel appreciated to this. So, I'm gonna try out the air dodge. So in the air, I can roll back. So basically, I can dodge in the air at any given time, when I'm in the air. Now this will be something that I'll definitely want to get, because this will help out. We have stiletto. Slash an opponent with incredible quickness and deliver a devastating thrusting attack. Can also be performed in the air. So basically again, so I press the left stick forward at any enemy twice quickly and press Y. This doesn't really feel like my style. This is one of my favorite moves. The breakdance. I basically do the splits and then spin your outstretched legs in this lunging kick attack. It can also be performed in the air. So basically once after I dodge and I hold down the right trigger, I can actually breakdance. So here's how it goes. I'm just gonna wait for me. So basically boom. That's why I love this move. And again, I can perform it in the air. And when I am breakdancing, I can actually move around. I just have to use my left stick to move around, but goddamn, I love this move. Woohoo! Spin around as I go. It could be some nice good coverage. So I'm gonna buy... Oh, I don't have enough currency right now to do it. That's a bummer. Well, I'm not too far away from getting it, but at least I bought the air dodge. And got Rodan's treasures, which I'll have to unlock. Basically, in terms, these will be outfits. So, that's all I can really do for right now. But at least I bought a way to dodge in the air, which can be really helpful. Hmm. Okay, let's actually progress a little further. Okay, that's one way. Which one am I supposed to go? Okay, go this way. Get more of these. There's another book over there. Vigrid Central Station. So this book is The Crystal Witch and Sage. So like I said, later on, I'll look at these books. Okay, I think I should be facing enemies here soon. Alright. And watch as the scenery blossoms. How it happens, I have no idea. But we could... But we're gonna have to sightsee later. Because not only do we have these normals, we also got a new enemy. It's big enough letters, you all can read the name. Alright, big gun. Let's show me what you got. Sorry over there. You have to do a transition to throw these torture attacks real quickly. Oh yeah, I can even actually use my own enemy's weapons against them. Get off. I don't want that. Get that out of here. Quick, quick. Yeah, still not the greatest in the world to this. Get them that iron maiden. Oh, dead nose over there. Yeah, they're simple enough enemies I can go shoot them. Oh, I noticed you over there, buddy. Ooh, boom! One shot, you're out of here. Yep. Another new enemy comes forth. Again, y'all can read the name. Because later on, there are going to be some names where I just can't pronounce them correctly. Woo-hoo! One time use. One time for the climax, where I summon my demon. Go, my dragon head! My num-nums. Yep, I can get bonuses. Whew. And we have a track. Break the gate. I think I'm probably gonna get maybe. Okay, I get gold. I knew I was gonna get gold. So yeah, I can actually use the Beloved's weapon. Alright, here we have a track. Basically, these golden LPs featuring the crystallized voices of angels, some sort of silhouette is drawn upon the surface. So yeah, I can use that at any given time. Open! No! Woo! Just like that. I love that. We'll get swung and you're out of here. I can just like slowly move myself in. Oh, cool. There's no way I can. Oh, I can throw like a boomerang. But I think I'm not quite sure if I actually dropped the weapon now. I'm gonna have to wrap this chapter up as quickly as possible. Cause I'm already running about. I'm already running about 25 minutes. Whoa! Okay, there it is. Get him over there. Woo! Yeah, I can't exactly reach him. Well, she's gone. Seen by the dragon. I'm sorry, I wish I could help. I'm sorry. Ah, I got hit. I missed timing. I can't exactly get up to it. All I can do is just shoot at him. Yeah, I saw that. That time I was actually great. Like, all I can really do is just shoot at him. Okay, no more chance. I should hit him. Ah, it was lagging up there. He's retreating. All just a daydream. And it's raining. Oh, I still kept my weapon. Okay, cool. I still kept it. Okay, got another book. I went through. And again, I can enter into the gates of hell, but I want to actually progress. Oh god. Yeah. I'm gonna turn around this up as fast as I can.
Points for Halos.
Yeah, I do. I do apologize for the commotion that was going on. Just some repair guy came in and looked at our air conditioning. That part I was not expecting at all, but thankfully this came right at the very end. So there's our little indication of where we're gonna go next. But that won't be until next episode. So before we end this off, we're gonna go enter the gates of hell and buy that break dance. So I can...
Well, well, an Angelic Hymns Gold LP.
Yep.
Got your hands on something off your bear, haven't you?
Yes, I did.
That thing is the perfect mate to coax out some of hell's ugliest.
Hmm.
One notice there is, and a damn who's who of Inferno comes born out of hell.
So what the guy did to me is he didn't mess up my recording.
Life into what I make best. Weapons of mass destruction. Tell you what, you give me that record and I'll
love mass destruction.
Angels will cry the sight of it. I'll just have to pop down to the tropics for a bit. So take a load off.
Onyx Roses, new weapons. Alright. So that's how much the Onyx Roses will be. But once I actually get more currency, I'll actually get it. Because right now, I want to buy me that Bright Dance. And there we go. But I'll probably show off some other techniques some other time. So. Let's exit the gates of hell because all I wanted was the break dance. Okay, guys, this video has gone on for more than half an hour now, so I'm gonna save up. So that'll do it for part 2 of Let's Play Bayonetta. So next time on Let's Play Bayonetta, we will take care of Chapter 2, Vigrid, City of Deja Vu. And as always, my outro will take care of the rest. So I will see you guys next time.